So in this particular video, we'll be talking about change in state and latent heat. Now we know, say suppose in a substance the molecules are close together. Say suppose this is solid. Now in liquid, the molecules are a bit far apart. Liquid. And in gas, they have huge distances. This is gas. So now, when energy is supplied to a solid, now you may have come across in chemistry, when energy is supplied, there is an increase in state of motion of the molecules. That is, there is intermolecular motion, that is intermolecular motion, and this increases with increase in energy that has been supplied. So if a molecule is given energy, then we know that it tries to break away from its bond, and because of the supply of heat, sometimes it becomes free. It becomes free from its initial bond. So solid after some time may convert into liquid because of the high increase in motion of their molecules or atoms. Solid converts into liquid because of the supply of heat. Now again, liquid, if more temperature is applied, converts into gas. So this is a change in state. Now say suppose for water, if you increase the temperature, it goes into gas, that is vapor. We know as vapor. Now if you decrease the temperature, it goes into solid, that is ice. So this is what we can understand by change in state. Now there is a point where liquid starts to convert into a solid, starts converting into a solid. There is a point. And for liquid, that is for water, we know that that point is 0 degrees Celsius. From 0 degrees Celsius to 100 degrees Celsius, we know that the water remains as liquid. Now, after that, it converts into vapor. And before that, it converts into ice. So this point where it converts, when the liquid starts to convert into solid, is known as its freezing point. Freezing point. And when the liquid, the temperature, when liquid starts to convert into gas, is known as its boiling point. Boiling point. So these are the stages, or these are the states at which we can observe a particular substance and how they change their state. Now in some substances you observe a curious phenomenon, that is from solid, after solid you have liquid and then you have gas depending upon your intermolecular forces of attraction. Now from solid, the intermolecular forces of attraction are huge. Because of the supply of energy, the intermolecular forces of attraction loosens. Therefore, there is a gradual change in state. But there are certain substances which undergoes a different change in state. That is, from solid, they straight away go to gas. And this process is known as sublimation. Sublimation. That is conversion of a state of solid directly to gas without going into the state of liquid is known as sublimation. So this is a definition that you can have. Now during sublimation, what you can observe is both the solid and vapor states of a substance coexist in thermal equilibrium. That is the solid and the gas, if they are in thermal equilibrium, during the process of sublimation, both coexist. So, if you want some example, you have dry ice. Dry ice, that is a solid CO2. So now let's have a discussion about latent key. Now, what you can observe is that, say suppose this is a block of ice. This is a block of ice. Now it is at a temperature of minus 17 degrees Celsius. Now you apply a heat and then it comes to the solid ice, comes to 0 degrees Celsius. But this is still in the formation of ice, that is the state is solid. The state at which it's existing is solid. Now after you apply some more amount of heat, say suppose you have applied a heat Q, the temperature won't be changing, but still you are applying heat. What you will observe is from this solid state, this ice converts into liquid state. This ice converts into liquid state and the temperature is still 0 degrees Celsius. Now after it has been fully converted into liquid, again with the application of heat, now the temperature will keep on rising, 1 degree Celsius, 2 degrees Celsius and so on. So now at this particular stage, if you observe, at this particular stage, even though we are applying heat, the temperature is not changing. What actually is changing is the state of matter. That is, ice can also exist at 0 degree, water can also exist at 0 degree. So, an amount of energy is required to convert this block of ice into water, and an amount of energy should be taken away, that is, heat energy should be taken away to convert this water into ice, into solid. So the extra amount of heat that is required to change the state without changing in temperature is known as latent heat. This is known as latent heat. So mathematically, latent heat is given by the amount of heat is actually equal to the mass into L, where L is known as the latent heat. This L is known as the latent heat. And it is one of the property of a substance. Latent heat is a property of a substance, that is, how much heat energy is required to change from one state to another. This is known as latent heat. Now, the value of L and the unit, first let's talk about the unit. This is what latent heat, this is the energy supplied. We know energy, that is heat energy, is in joule, M is in kilogram. So latent heat, the unit of latent heat will be given as L equals to Q by M. This is joule and this is kilogram. So unit of latent heat, as we know, is joule per kg. This is unit of latent. Now, say suppose the latent heat for a solid liquid state. Now, as we have discussed, this is a solid and this is a liquid state. So, for a solid liquid state, what we have is latent heat of fusion. That is, this particular solid liquid state is known as latent heat of fusion. Now, if you want to change from liquid to gas, that is from change from liquid to gas, now in 100 degrees Celsius, water can also exist and vapors can also exist. So, the amount of heat energy required to transform this water into gas is latent heat of vaporization. Vaporization. Now, from liquid to gas is known as latent heat of vaporization, and from solid to liquid is known as latent heat of fusion. This is denoted by LF and this is denoted by LV. Latent heat of vaporization and latent heat of fusion.